Every 32 minutes, someone is killed by an impaired driver in the United States.
Mitchell, Medic 5-1 arriving. Two vehicle injury accident. We'll be investigating. Medic 5-1 will be establishing camp structure.
To demonstrate the severity of the decision to drink and drive, a mock fatality crash was put on Wednesday by students from North Mason High School and the Region 2 Target Zero Task Force. The student body filled the stands at Phil Pugh Stadium to watch as emergency crews responded to the two-car fatal head-on collision caused by a drunk driver.
Based on Medic 5-1, we have four patients, one black, one yellow, one red, and one green. Continue additional units priority, please.
The black patient means that one person is dead. That person went through the windshield and was lying on the hood of one of the cars. The yellow patient means serious injuries. That person was transported to a hospital. The red patient means critical injuries, and Airlift Northwest was called in. And the green means minor injuries, and that person walked away from the crash. While firefighters and paramedics worked to free those trapped in one of the vehicles, the State Patrol responded and conducted a field sobriety test on the uninjured causing driver.
Okay, well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you to please come on to report the voluntary sobriety test. Okay, go ahead and stand with your feet together, like fine. Keep your hands at your sides.
The driver was arrested and taken into custody.
You are under arrest for DUI.
Mason County Coroner Wes Stockwell also responded and removed the deceased passenger.
North Mason students, this is a reenactment of an unfortunate event that is preventable. Nationally, every 32 minutes, someone is killed by an impaired driver. Of this reenactment, two patients will die, and one will face years in prison. Again, this event is preventable.
The demonstration didn't end there. Every 32 minutes throughout the day, the coroner would enter a classroom and place a student on a gurney, removing them as an obituary was read over the school's intercom.
Alex Heath Aaron Gobble was 16 years old. He was deeply involved in his church new life and also loved to participate in plays and musicals. He was an amazing actor, and whenever he was on stage, you were just drawn into whatever he was saying. I got to see him speak on stage at a
Those students were then isolated for 24 hours. Aiden Wielander helped organize this exercise.
I don't want to see any North Mason students get killed from impaired driving. That was my goal.
Other participating agencies included the Mason County Sheriff's Office, North Mason Regional Fire Authority, Central Mason Fire and EMS, Mason County Fire District 3, and MACECOM, Mason County Emergency Communications. Belfair Auto Wrecking provided the cars. Reporting for MasonWebTV.com and Hood Canal Communications HCC.net, I'm Diedrich Allen.